Last week, Minister Agnes Nandutu, through her lawyer, Caleb Alaka, filed an application before the Anti-Corruption Court to have her trial halted, pending a determination of a petition she had filed before the Constitutional Court seeking interpretation over the charges against her, which she says contravene Article 28, 1 and 12 of the Constitution.
The section under which the person has been charged is indeed unconstitutional. And my lord, whatever the case, the Constitutional Court can interpret that section and say it's constitutional, and the trial continues.
Alaka stated that Section 21A1 of the Anti-Corruption Act of 2009, in which Nandutu was charged with dealing with suspect property, is vague, broad and ambiguous.
It is unfair, unconstitutional for a person to go through a trial when the provisions of the law under which that person has been charged are vague, ambiguous, broad, and imprecise.
He went ahead and demanded that the Anti-Corruption Court hold Nandutu's trial pending determination of a petition she filed. However, today, Lady Justice Jane Okuo-Kajuga said there is nothing ambiguous or vague in the law as alleged by Nandutu.
The definition given, or the wording of the section, should be so unclear and indefinite as to not to give a person of ordinary intelligence the opportunity to know what is prohibited. That is it. When I look at the wording of the section, I believe that before I can refer it to the Constitutional Court, I must on the face of it be satisfied that there is ambiguity. And of that, I am not convinced.
The judge, however, noted that having filed a petition at the Constitutional Court, there is no need to file another application in the Anti-Corruption Court, as this would lead to case backlog. She asked the state to continue with its case.
Because I believe that the Constitutional Court, being vested with the jurisdiction to hear the substance of the matter, is better placed to determine whether a grant of stay is justicious or not.
The case has been adjourned to June 8, 2023. Minister Agnes Nandutu is charged with dealing with suspect property contrary to Section 21A1 of the Anti-Corruption Act of 2009. Under the charge, the Director of Public Prosecutions contends that during the month of June 2022, at the OPM stores in Namave, Mukono District, and at Kola Cell, Bulwanyi Parish in Mukono District, the minister dealt with 2,000 pre-painted iron sheets of gauge 28 by receiving and holding the said iron sheets, which she had reason to believe were acquired as a result of loss of public property, an offence under Section 10(1) of the Anti-Corruption Act. Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.